past it now. King, Cawdor, Glamis, all as the weird women promised, and I fear thou playedst most foully for it. Yet it was said, and it should not stand in thy posterity, but that myself should be the root and father of many kings. There come truth from them, as upon thee, Macbeth, their speeches shine. Why, by the verities on thee make good, may they not be my oracles as well, and set me up in hope. But hush, no more.
Ah, here's our chief guest. Tonight we hold a solemn supper, sir, and I'll request your presence.
Let your highness command upon me, to the which my duties are with the most indissoluble tie forever knit.
Ride you this afternoon.
Aye, my good lord.
We should have else desired your good advice in this day's council, but we'll take tomorrow. Is it far you ride?
As far, my lord, as to fill up the time twixt this and supper.
Fail not our feast.
My lord, I will not.
Till return at night. I eat a horse. Goes Fleance with you.
Aye, my lord. Our time does call upon us.
I wish your horses swift and sure of foot, and so I do commend you to their backs. Farewell. Let every man be master of his time till 7 at night. To make society the sweeter welcome, we will keep ourselves alone till supper time. Why then, God be with you. Sirrah, a word. Attend those men our pleasure.
They are, my lord, without the palace gate.
Bring them before us. To be thus is nothing, but to be safely thus. Our fears in Banquo stick deep. There's none but he whose being I do fear. He chid the sisters when first they put name of king upon me, and bade them speak to him. Then, prophet-like, they hailed him father to a line of kings. If it be so, for Banquo's issue have I filed my mind. For them the gracious Duncan have I murdered, to make them kings, the seeds of Banquo kings. Who's there? Now go to the door and stay there till we call. Was it not yesterday we spoke together?
It was, so please, your highness.
Well then, now have you considered my speeches? Know that it was Banquo in times past which held you so under fortune, which you had thought had been our innocent self.
You made it known to us.
Are you so gospeled to pray for this good man and his issue, whose heavy hand hath bowed you to the grave and beggared yours forever?
We are men, my liege.
I am the catalogue ye go for men. As hounds, greyhounds, mongrels, spaniels, curs, shows, water rugs, demi-wolves are all clept by the name of dogs.
I am one, my liege, whom the vile blows and buffets of the world hath so incensed, that I am reckless what I do to spite the world.
And I another.
Both of you know Banquo was your enemy.
Oh, true, my lord.
So he is mine. And though I could with barefaced power sweep him from my sight, yet I must not. Thence it is that I, to your assistance, do make love, masking the business from the common eye for sundry weighty reasons.
We shall, my lord, perform where you command us.
Your spirit shine through you. Within this hour at most, I will advise you where to plant yourselves, and with him Fleance, his son, that keeps him company, whose absence is no less material to me than is his father's, must embrace the fate of that dark hour. Resolve yourselves apart. I'll come to you anon.
We are resolved.
My
lord.
I'll call upon you straight. Abide within. It is concluded. Banquo, thy soul's flight, if it find heaven, must find it out tonight.
How now, my lord? Why do you keep alone? What's done is done.
We have scorched the snake, not killed it. Ere we will eat our meal in fear and sleep in the affliction of these terrible dreams that shake us nightly. Better be with the dead, whom we, to gain our peace, have sent to peace, than on the torture of the mind to lie in restless ecstasy. Duncan is in his grave. After life's fitful fever, he sleeps well. Treason has done his worst. Nothing can touch him further.
Come on, gentle, my lord. Sleek o'er your rugged looks. Be bright and jovial among your guests tonight.
So shall I love, and so I pray be you.
You must leave this.
Oh, full of scorpions is my mind, dear wife. Thou knowest that Banquo and his fleance lives.
But in them nature's copies not etern.
There's comfort yet. They are assailable.
What have you done?
Be innocent of the knowledge, dearest Chuck. Till thou applaud the deed. Thou marvelest at my words, but hold thee still. Things bad begun make strong themselves by ill. So prithee, go with me.
A light! A light!
Tis he, stand to it.
It will be rain tonight.
Look!
Trickery!
Is done.
And play the humble host. Our hostess keeps her state, but in best time we will require her welcome.
Pronounce it for me, sir, to all our friends, for my heart speaks they are welcome.
To say they accompany with their heart's thanks. The table is even.
Be large and well.
A nod will drink a measure the table round. There's blood upon my face.
It's Banquo's then.
'Tis better thee without than he within. Is he dispatched?
My lord, his throat is cut. That I did for him.
Thou art the best of the cutthroats. Yet he's good that did the like for Fleance. If thou didst it, thou art the nonpareil.
Most royal sir, Fleance has escaped.
Then comes my fit again. I have else been perfect, but now I am cabin, crib, confined, bound into saucy doubts and fears. But Banquo's safe.
Aye, my good lord, safe in a ditch he bides, with 20 trenchant gashes on his head, the least a death to nature.
Thanks for that. Get thee gone, we'll hear ourselves again tomorrow.
Oh, my royal lord, you do not give the cheer.
Sweet remembrance, sir. Now, good digestion, wait on appetite, and
Health on both.
May please your highness sit. Here had we now our country's honor roofed, with the gracious person of our Banquo present.
His absence, sir, lays blame upon his promise. Please let your highness to grace us with your royal
The table's full. Here is a place reserved, sir.
Where?
Here, my good lord.
Oh!
What is it?
Which of you have done this?
Done what, my lord?
Oh, thou canst not see I did it. Never shake thy glory not at me.
Gentlemen,
no!
Sit, worthy.
No!
My lord is often thus and hath been from
his No!
The fit is momentary. No! I thought he will be again well.
No!
Are you a man?
I had a bold with that don't dare look on that which might have called the devil.
But this is the very air drawn dagger which you said led you to Duncan. Shame itself. Why do you make such faces? When all's done, you look but on a stool.
No! Prithee, behold. Look, see there.
Lo, how say you? What care I that thou canst not speak to? If I stand here, I saw him.
My worthy lord, your noble friends do lack you.
I do forget. Do not use at me, my most worthy friend. I have a strange infirmity which is nothing to those that know me. Come, love and health to all. Then I'll sit down. Now, give me some wine. Fill full. I drink to the general joy of the whole table and to our dear friend Banquo, whom we miss. Would he were here. To all, and him we thirst, and all to all.
Our duties and the pledge.
My sight. Let the earth hide thee. Thy bones are marrowless, thy blood is cold. There is no speculation in those eyes which thou doth stare with. What man dare I dare? Take any shape but that, and my firm nerves will never shake with fear. Hence, horrible shadow, unreal mockery, hence!
So being gone, I am a man again. I pray you sit.
You have displaced the mirth, broke the good meeting with most admired disorder.
You make me strange, even to the disposition that I owe, and now I think you can behold such sights and keep the natural ruby of your cheek when mine is blanched with fear.
What sights, my lord?
I pray you speak not. He grows worse and worse. Question enrages him. At once. Good night. Stand not upon the order of your going, but go at once.
Good night, and better health attend his majesty.
Go!
It will have blood, they say. Blood will have blood. What is the night?
Almost at odds with morning, which is which?
How sayest thou that Macduff denies his person at our great bidding?
Did you send to him, sir?
I hear it by the way, but I will send. There's not a one of them, but is this house I keep a servant feed. I will tomorrow to the weird sisters. More shall they speak, for now I am bent to know the worst means the worst. I am in blood, steeped in so far that should I wait no more, returning were as tedious as go o'er. Strange things I have in head which will to hand, which must be acted ere they may be scanned.
You lack the season of all natures. Sleep.
Come, will to sleep. I
strange and self-abuse is the initiate fear that wants hard use. We are but young indeed.